This is the stunning backdrop that you'll see in Kuala Lumpur, capital of Malaysia. An even more stunning badminton right here at the Axiata Arena, part of the Bukit Jalil Sports Complex. An incredible state-of-the-art arena here to watch some of the best badminton players from around the world gathered here for the HSBC BWF Malaysia Open 2024. It is quarterfinal day here, and we're into the second session of play very shortly indeed. And that is what they're all going to be looking out for, the World Tour Finals Trophy. We're the very first tournament of the tour this year. Bringing out that trophy is Kang Kai-shing, a Malaysian national junior player. And one day I'm sure he'll be hoping to be playing right here in this tournament. So, session two, as I mentioned, we have got five matches for you this afternoon and into the early evening. Start with the men's singles. Exciting to watch Lin Chun-Yi against Li Shi Feng, the third seed from China. And then into the women's doubles, the fifth seeds, Zhang Xuxian and Zheng Yu, will take on the Japanese pair of Reina Miura and Ayako Sakuramoto. Moving to the women's singles, really good to see Akane Yamaguchi back, the 13 from Japan, takes on Zhang Yiman of China in what will be an intriguing encounter. And then one that I think will be really exciting, Liang Weikeng and Wang Cheng, the top seeds from China in the men's doubles. They'll be playing Fajar Alfian and Muhammad Rian Ardianto, former world number ones. They are the fifth seeds here from Indonesia. And we'll end things off with more men's doubles action with He Jiting and Rong Xiangyu of China taking on India's second-seeded pair of Satwik Sairaj Rankireddy and Chirag Shetty. Lots to keep the fans excited about. Some top, top names in action here on court two. Looking at the men's singles bracket, that's where, of course, we are starting our action. And lots of great matchups there for you. I think the one that catches the eye, I think from a neutral perspective, is right at the bottom there, Anders Hansen versus Koda Naroka. If you watch them in action in Shenzhen, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about with how those two carried on in that match. But our attention's, of course, the match above it. Lin Chun-Yi and Li Shi Feng, the winner of that, will play the winner of Antonsen versus Naraoka. Well, these fans, I'll tell you what, it has been a great crowd here over the last few days, and will only get better as we head towards the weekend. More and more coming in, of course. Badminton, a hugely popular sport. Malaysia, of course, one of the big nations within the sport. There are still Malaysian representatives in the men's doubles. They'll be playing on court one. And they'll be really getting behind. There's been a real partisan crowd, a really nice feel about it, I have to say. So, we have Lin Chun-Yi walking out first here. So these two have met twice before. It currently stands at one apiece. Their last meeting at the German Open. Li Shifeng winning that two very contrasting games there. 21-7 and then 22-20. Prior to that, they met in 2019. US Open round of 16, Lin Chun-Yi winning that one in three games. I think pretty much to scout that one such a long time ago. A lot has changed since then. So Lin Chun-Yi is 24 years of age, 180 centimeters tall. He's currently playing at his best ever ranking of 21st in the world. And he has won three titles on the World Tour. The US Open back in 2019, the tournament actually that he beat his current opponent. He's beaten two pretty big names, and look at that, beating the world champ, Gunnlaugur Vittetson, in straight games, the fifth seed, world champion. That is a fantastic achievement, isn't it? He's won the US Open in 2019, and last year, great couple of results, Kaohsiung Masters, and which is a Super 100, and the Thailand Masters, a Super 300. Li Shifeng is 24 years of age. He's just a bit taller, 6 foot. And he's ranked at his highest as well, third in the world. Been a really good rise for him as well. Asian Games gold medal winner not too long ago. And also a former Youth Olympic champion in 2018. A couple of big, long matches, isn't he? Li Chiahao and then Wang Hongyang, his compatriot. Is he going to be a little sapped by that? We will see. Zuraini of Malaysia is our umpire. Michael Putz of Germany will be our service judge. So Li Shifeng has got as many titles as his opponent, 2019, same year that Lin Chun-Yi won his first, the Canada Open. That's a Super 100. He then won All England, stunningly beating Shi Yuqi last year. And the US Open, he beat Kudlavut as well, just before the world champs. And he was runner-up at the Canada Open, the Super 500, where he lost to Lakshya Sen. And he also lost to Jonathan Christie in the final of the French Open late last year. So it's the world number 3 versus the world number 21. Lin Chun-Yi comes into this as the underdog. Having also lost the last time they played, which was in March of last year.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Lin Chun-Yi, Chinese Taipei. And on my left, Li Shifeng, China. Lin Chun-Yi to serve, love all, play.
Just a little bit of that drift coming from behind today. So we're just going to keep an eye on, but generally, players have preferred this end, this closer end. Lin Chun-Yi, when he gets into his forehand smash. There you go. Thank you for stood straight to my point there. Packs a real punch with this one. Not so much power, but great accuracy. Cross court. What? 49 matches on the World Tour, 129, lost 20. Lovely show. He's looking at a real array of shots here. Just out, first point on the board for Lin Chun-Yi.
Service over. 1-3.
That's good. Went right towards him. Difficult to really maneuver to get a shot away. Yeah, played that quite low, didn't he? It's difficult for him to return that from there. Chun-Yi at the moment feels like he's sort of dictating proceedings early on. Got to the final of the Thailand Masters course, which he won. Quarterfinals of the German Open. Semis of the Malaysian Masters. Quarters of the Chinese Taipei Open. The US Open semi-finals, where he lost to Quinlevitz, who then lost to Lin Chun-Yi. Excuse me, he beat Quinlevitz, excuse me, I should say. Chun-Yi. Lead, very useful for him. So I just cracked myself. He lost to Quinlevitz, and then Quinlevitz lost to Lin Chun-Yi in the final. Just got a bit long again. It's going to happen.
7-2.
Got to the final. I've won the Kaohsiung Masters. And a quarterfinals of the career Masters. Had a fairly decent year. This time he gets to it, Lin Chun-Yi. Really unleashed his jump smash just yet, but there he does. Again, I don't think he's fully going for it yet. Eight, know how powerful he can smash. He's got an 8-2 lead here. Lin Chun-Yi, last year, 65 matches played, 48 wins, 17 defeats. Pretty good, isn't it, that record? Quickly whipped it back, difficult then for Lin Chun-Yi.
3-8.
Five points now. That run comes to an end for Lin Chun-Yi. There you go again, brilliant on that cross court smash. That's worked for him twice now.
9-3.
So effective. No chance for his opponent.
Can you shortest one.
This is what he is looking to try and avoid. Shi Feng. Unleashing that smash. Accuracy has been excellent so far. It's been a brilliant start for Lin Chun-Yi. Lin Chun-Yi. He is kind of struggling at the moment, isn't he? I said he had a pretty good year last year. Quarterfinals of the India Open, the semis of the Thailand Masters. He lost in the final of the German Open, won All England, which was a great result. Quarters of the Asia Championships where he lost to Ginting.
11-4.
Goes the interval here with Lin Chun-Yi, a whopping 7 points up, 11-4. Very quickly, Lin Chun-Yi got to, Shi Feng, quarters of the Singapore Open, semis of the Indonesia Open, lost in the final of the Canada Open, then won the US Open the following week. And then, of course, that gold in the Asia Games. And then losing the final to the French Open. Great bunch of results for him. The sheer power of that carries it over. Now, if you don't lift enough, with enough depth or height, someone like Lin Chun-Yi is going to punish you. You have to get that absolute spot on. Well, his career so far, Lin Chun-Yi has played in 10 quarterfinals and won 6 of those.
Well, 4.
He's never been in a Super 1000 quarterfinal before, so this is a big, big deal for him.
Five, 12.
That's a 7-point cushion. looking very, very confident.
35.
Shi Feng is a dab hander. It's a long shot at 38 shots. Quarterfinals of 2023, he got to 9 of them. He won 7 out of 9, 4 in a row. The two he lost were actually against Ginting at the Singapore Open and the India Open. One player, therefore, has beaten him in the last year, quarterfinals. And in his career, he's been 17. Quarterfinals. He won 11 of the 17. So, really, you'd have to say last year was the sort of the breakout year for him. Sometimes that's happened where he's just played too light a touch on it. A couple of these unforced errors, very wayward shots.
40.
Lin Chun-Yi. Excellent work from Li Shi Feng. He's trying to narrow
14.
That gap. He still trails by 5. And he wants to kind of put an end to this run quickly if he can. It's not the biggest run, but 4 points. Won't go over.
10.
Starting
40.
To look a little menacing now. His best run thus far by a long shot. Li Shi Feng. Clips the net. Ooh, I thought that was out. And it's going to be a challenge, unsurprisingly. Yeah, it's good.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. Service over.
Yeah, he needed to just end that, didn't he? Nip that one in the bud. Lin Chun-Yi, because it was starting to look menacing for him, threatening.
Service over.
It was a 5-point run.
11-15.
could have been going out. That has been a little problem for him there, hasn't it? The conditions, perhaps.
4 points, 11. I
think, for him. Remember that lead at one point was 14-5, 9 points. We are back up to 6 here. Again, this is what he wants. He wants these lofted shots to him. Just a bit long himself here. Seven of the last 10 points have gone Li Shi Feng's way. So he's kind of got himself back into this. But has he left it a little late? Is it just too far away? He's still trailing by 5. Just where he wants it. Perfect. Wonderfully constructed point there by Lin Chun-Yi.
18. Well.
He's almost there.
Well,
Lin Chun-Yi. It was just too far, wasn't it? It was 2 runs of points for Lin Chun-Yi. That's out. Game points here for Lin Chun-Yi. That's a fine first game win there for Lin Chun-Yi. Really played well right from the very start, has led throughout this first game. Was 11-4 at the interval, thanks to a 5-point run a bit earlier on. And a good fight back from Li Shi Feng. But he himself had a 5-point run, but it wasn't to be enough. Thank you.
Court 2, 20 seconds. Court 2, 20 seconds. Players back on court. Second game, love all, play.
So now let's see how Li Shifeng reacts to this. Lin Chun-Yi is on this end now, which is what we're seeing, the drift probably just a bit behind him. Might quite enjoy that, actually. Just gonna watch the power with which he puts into his smashes. There you go. He's enjoying himself. Another great cross-court shot. Yeah. Shi Feng just playing that shuttle back to his opponent, just to see, perhaps see if there's any drift there. There was some sideways drift earlier in the week. Going towards the left. Certainly, the momentum is with this man. He's won the last 6 points on the trot going back to their last game. A kind of a similar start to what we had in the previous game, where we took a three-point lead. Lin Chun-Yi. His opponent got a couple back, and then Lin raced to 8-2 and never looked back. Oh, he was unlucky. He desperately needed that, didn't he? He wanted that, he was willing it. I think had that not been in, he wouldn't have got there. Li Shifeng. Couple back here.
Four. Don't celebrate first.
Told to just cut out the exuberance. match has tumbled over. So he's now hit back with four points of his own after a great start from Lin Chun-Yi. Nothing at all that anyone can do when that happens. Again, beautifully executed.
Service over. Five, four.
Further extends that lead again. It's kind of swinging back and forth, this one, isn't it?
Service over. Five, six.
Slightly different feel to this second game. Onto that overhead, it's very, very tricky.
7-5.
Four points clear again.
Service over. 6-9.
Starting to bring his way back into this. Yeah, he's clawing his way back, so every time he faces that deficit, he... Lin Chun-Yi is just hung in there, he just doesn't want to let... Chun-Yi run away with it.
Service over. Ten, eight. service over. 9-10.
He goes 11, into the interval with a two-point lead here, Lin Chun-Yi. It's not as big as what he had in the previous game, which he went on to win, but he's in a decent position at the moment. Player from Chinese Taipei.
Yes, they want to talk.
Confidence, Lin Chun-Yi. You can see that coursing through his veins, the way he's taking it on. Again, 4-point lead. It's been as good as it's got so far for Lin Chun-Yi. Can he push that even more? Get that distance between him and the world number three. Yes, he can. Big roar from him as well.
49.
He is on a roll now.
59.
Getting very, very tricky. For Li Shi Feng, who's down by 6. Is the writing perhaps on the wall here? Desperately needed something, didn't he?
Service over.
He's never 10, lost to anyone 15. From Chinese Taipei in a quarterfinal. Won all three matches previously, including one against Lin Chun-Yi back in the German Open of last year. in March.
Service over.
And generally 16, against Chinese Taipei 10. Players, he's won 7 out of 9. Only one of two players who's ever beaten him is Lin Chun-Yi. That was the US Open in 2019. Oh, he's aggressive. He went for that.
Service over.
Still a very nice 5-point lead here.
Okay, on the court.
As for Lin Chun-Yi, his record against Chinese players on the World Tour.
11-16.
In quarterfinals, he's lost both of them. One of them, Mu Guangzhu, the other, Shi Feng, as I mentioned. And overall, against Chinese players, he's won 7 out of 13. It's a pretty good record.
12-16.
Is he making his move here? This would be a big moment for Lin Chun-Yi. He can get this scalp. It's out, it's wide. He's 5 times previously played top 5 players in the world. He's only won once, that was against Kodai Naraoka when he was number 3 in the world, the Malaysia Masters. Malaysia, a happy hunting ground in that sense. Gonna happen again for him. He is looking good here. Now, treatment required, it appears, for Li Shi Feng. He's in fact never won. He's only ever once before won a game against a top 5 player. That was against Lin Chun, against Kodai Naraoka, who he went on to beat. In fact, it was an incredible second game where he won 30-29. Took 2 hours that match. Trying to spray himself. Very heavily strapped up the right leg. Maybe tweaking that as he landed on his left foot.
Shi Feng. It must not open his shoes before the medical. Seventeen, 12.
Played in the World Tour Finals and Kim Lovett and Jonathan Christie lost to Anders Antonsen. Last tournament before he came here. Delicate phase now of this match because has to get a run here. Shi Feng. And he can't. Again, brilliant shot from Lin, who's not just a power merchant.
80-12.
This would be huge for him to beat a second world number three player, Lin Chun-Yi, and get himself into the semi-final of a Super 1000. That would be massive. Oof, it's just in.
Service over. 13-18.
Reminder again, it was 15-9. All three, the last 7 points have gone in favour of Li Shifeng, so it's still tight. He needs much more than that, Li. Say it gets too nervy yet for Lin Chun-Yi, but remember, he can stumble, still afford to get to 21. He's got enough of a cushion. Now, it is only 3 points between them.
Six. 15, 18.
Now, he might just start to get a little nervous. Lin Chun-Yi. Doing what he's done earlier. This is excellent work from Li Shifeng. He's hunting down this lead. Reminder again. It was 16-10. 6-2. It has been a 4-point run at the moment. Six of the last eight have gone Li Shifeng's way. This is now Lin Chun-Yi's got to keep his cool if he wants to go on and win this in straights. There he is, that was important. Really important for him. And you can see what it means to him.
Service over. 19,
just to give him that little 16. Bit more breathing space. Just a tad too much on it.
Service over.
It was a right idea. There's plenty of court to aim at.
19.
Very tight. Doesn't go for the challenge. And yeah, he probably would have got that wrong anyway. Can't relax yet. The finish line is tantalizingly in sight for Lin Chun-Yi. It is very good. And he's got three match points, Lin Chun-Yi.
20, match point 70.
This would be an upset of fairly decent proportions here. Points. That's too long. Still two match points to go. Lee Chun-Yi, he's got to keep his nerve. Li Shufeng hasn't lost to a player ranked this low, and it's not that low, but he's 24th in the world, but he lost to Tuma Junior Popov, who was 26th then in the world, at the Denmark Open in October last year. He was number 6, Popov was number 26. And he's done it, Lin Chun-Yi, into his first Super 1000 semi-final. And he's done it by beating the world number 3. Only the second time he's ever managed to do that feat. Did it last year against Kodai Naraoka. And he's done it here. He's done it superbly as well. He has never lost the lead in this match.
Match won by Lin Chun-Yi, 21-12, 21-18.
What a result for Lin Chun-Yi. He played with real confidence right from the very beginning. Excellent work for Lin Chun-Yi of Chinese Taipei, who defeats the third seed from China, Li Shifeng, 21-12, 21-18. He's done it in 49 minutes. So many fans streaming in to watch what has been a fantastic spectacle here at the Asiata Arena for the HSBC BWF Malaysia Open